Hola amigos and welcome to Learn Everything Online. In the previous chapter, we saw how to greet anyone informally or by saying hola and introducing yourself. In this chapter, we will see how to greet anyone in formal situations or someone who is at higher authority. So without any delay, let's get started. Welcome to chapter 2 of our Spanish tutorials. The name of this chapter is Formal Greetings. Now, like we saw in the last chapter, the word for hello is hola. Now, hola can be used in the formal as well as informal sense. But what if we are in some situation where we have people from higher authority or in some situations like we are in an office? So at that time, greeting hola is also fine. But you can use different things like good morning, good afternoon or good evening. So for that, the word good is common, isn't it? So let us see first, the word for good in Spanish is bueno, bueno. And the word for morning in Spanish is días. So the word good morning becomes bueno días. But a small change, while saying good morning, we add an S at the end of bueno, making it buenos días. Good morning, buenos días. The second greeting that we use is good afternoon or evening. So for that, the word for afternoon and evening is the same, which is tardes. Tardes. So the whole greeting good afternoon or good evening becomes buenas tardes. Now in Spanish, there is a rule that the adjectives and the verbs take the ending as according to the gender of the noun. We will see all of this in detail in further lectures. But for now, remember that tarde is the main basic noun, is feminine. That is why the adjective changed its end from O to A. And then it became buenas tardes. So good afternoon or good evening is buenas tardes. Now the next one is good night or good evening. Now the word for night and evening is also same. Now you'll wonder why. So as long as there is light outside and it is evening, we use tardes. But what if it is evening and it is dark outside? At that time, we will use noche. Noche. So to wish good night or good evening, we use buenas noches. Now after greeting someone good morning or good afternoon, we would ask the further question, that is, how are you? So to say how are you in Spanish, we have ¿Cómo está? ¿Cómo está? Now the literal meaning of the word is ¿Cómo? Meaning how, and está meaning are you. That becomes ¿Cómo está? How are you? Now ¿Cómo está? Is a formal version of how are you. Now what if you're greeting your family members or friends? At that time, we will use the informal version of how are you, that is ¿Cómo estás? Just adding an S at the end of está makes it informal. ¿Cómo estás? Now try saying this sentence in Spanish. Good morning, how are you? Buenos días, ¿cómo está? Or in informal sense, buenos días. ¿Cómo estás? Now all these greetings and the question how are you is used or will be used when you are the first person introducing yourself or you are the first person to speak. But what if you are being introduced by someone or someone else is introducing you to themselves to yourself? How will you respond at this situation? So the formal response for any language or for the formal response for how are you is very well, thank you, isn't it? So for now we require three words, very well and thank you. So the very first word that we'll see is very. The word for very is muy. The UY at the end is a little stretched. Muy. So very well becomes bien is the word for well. So very well becomes muy bien. The next thing after saying very well, we'll say thank you, isn't it? So thank you. Very well, thank you. Thank you is gracias. Gracias. If you want to say thank you very much, we have an extra word just before gracias, which is muchas. Now, if you remember, in the last lecture, we saw the word mucho. Yes, this is the feminine form of this word, muchas, having the same meaning, many or much. So, this is many thanks, meaning muchas gracias. Now, if the two say the full thing, we have very well, thank you. Muy bien, gracias. Now, to help out this guy, what would his response be? Muy bien, gracias. The next formal statement or the formal word or commonly used statement is excuse me. This can be used when you are trying to call someone or when you bump into someone accidentally on the road and say excuse me. So the word for excuse me is disculpe. Disculpe. Another word for excuse me can be perdone. You can use any of the two words as long as you're comfortable with any one of them. Perdone. So how would you say this? Excuse me. Good afternoon. I am Raj. Disculpe. Buenas tardes. Soy Raj. Now the word excuse me is perdone. Now perdone can also mean sorry in situations like bumping into someone accidentally. At that time we say sorry or excuse me, perdone. But if when you want to really apologize to someone, we say I am sorry. So the word for that is lo siento. Lo siento. The literal meaning of the word is lo meaning it. Siento meaning I feel. So this word translates to I feel it. I am sorry. Lo siento. Now, before ending it, we will say, see you later. Hasta luego. Hasta luego. The H of hasta is silent again, like in hola. Hasta luego. The literal meaning for that is hasta, until, luego, then. So it is literally until then, hasta luego. And like we say in English, until then, goodbye. So what would you say for see you later? Bye. Hasta luego. Adios. So I hope it was easy and you understood. If you have any questions or queries, please drop them in the comment section and I'll try to answer all of them. Thank you.
So I hope it was easy and you got the hang of it. So do not forget to share this video with your friends and family. Tell me in the comment section how you liked the video and do not forget to subscribe our channel and hit the bell icon. I'll see you in the next lecture. Thank you.